Hey everyone, welcome to Integrated Medical Biochemistry with Dr. Bijoya.
Hello everyone, today we'll talk about the effect of ethyl alcohol on fat metabolism. This is under the heading Alcohol Metabolism. This is the part 4 of the lecture series. So, ethanol is converted to acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde is converted to acetate. Now there are two different enzymes which can carry out the first reaction. Now ethanol is more commonly converted to acetaldehyde by alcohol dehydrogenase, whereas under high alcohol concentration there is a second enzyme that becomes activated, which is found in the microsomes, that is cytochrome P450 CYP2E1. This enzyme activity increases the cancer risk. Now, aldehyde is also carcinogenic. Aldehyde, if it is not converted quickly into acetate, this is going to have deleterious effects on the body. The low enzyme activity of aldehyde dehydrogenase, which converts acetaldehyde to acetate, will increase the risk of cancer or other disorders. So let us look at the various lipid metabolic pathways that are affected. So these are the various metabolic changes that the liver will undergo during ethanol metabolism. When the NADH to NAD ratio rises, the first pathway to be affected is glycolysis. The equilibrium will shift here after fructose 1,6 bisphosphate cleaves into dihydroxyacetone phosphate and 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. The dihydroxyacetone phosphate will shift to forming 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. So there will be a shift in the equilibrium and more of 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde will be formed. The second thing that will happen is there will be reduction in gluconeogenesis. Now, because of reduction in gluconeogenesis, the patient will have hypoglycemia. So what will happen is, because there is hypoglycemia and there is no gluconeogenesis, glucagon hormone will raise and it will start its action on the adipocytes, and the adipocytes will be activating hormone sensitive lipase enzyme. So since you know that adipocytes store triacylglycerol, now triacylglycerol will be catalyzed into free fatty acids and glycerol by hormone sensitive lipase. Now both these products will move into the circulation and they will reach the liver. So in the liver, free fatty acids and glycerol would like to enter the mitochondria for beta oxidation, but this will not occur because of decreased beta oxidation, because there is already very high level of NADH and to NAD ratio. So there is no NAD plus available to be consumed by the beta oxidation pathway. So this pathway will be inhibited. So now what will happen to the free fatty acid and glycerol? Now what will happen is these will now go to smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Now in smooth endoplasmic reticulum, this phosphoglyceraldehyde from glycolysis will be converted to glycerol and it will reach the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and here it will react with fatty acid to form triacylglycerol. So glycerol plus fatty acid will once again form glycerol, but due to decreased VLDL formation, this will remain in the liver itself, and so this will cause steatosis, that is there will be droplets of fat seen in the hepatocytes. So this is the whole mechanism of metabolic changes in liver. Now, because of acetaldehyde and CYP2E1, apart from steatosis, that is deposition of oil droplets in liver, there are various other things that will metabolites that will be generated, that is reactive oxygen species, which will cause damage to DNA and RNA. They will also cause lipid peroxidation, and because of this reactive oxygen species, mitochondrial damage will also occur. Proteins will be damaged, and there will be depletion of glutathione, which is an enzyme of antioxidant system. So all this together will lead to oxidative stress, inflammation, apoptosis, metabolic disorders, and it may also lead to cancer in the end. So because of these things happening in the liver will undergo gradual changes over a long period of time. So initially it will be a healthy liver, then it will turn to fatty liver, then there will be fibrosis of liver, and which will finally lead to cirrhosis of the liver. So these are the stages of liver damage that may a person may undergo on chronic intake of alcoholism over a long period of time. Now let us see a picture of hepatic steatosis. So this is a normal liver. You can see this microscopic examination of a hepatocyte, and this is a fatty liver where there you can see droplets of oil or triglycerides are present in the hepatocytes. So this is the difference between a normal hepatocyte and a hepatocyte which has oil or triglyceride deposits. So now let us look at the changes that a normal liver undergoes on chronic and excessive alcohol consumption. Now all these changes, as we have already discussed, occurs due to alteration in the fatty acid metabolism, where there is increased fatty acid synthesis, increased triacylglycerol formation, and all this is occurring in the liver. But the other change that occurs is that there is decreased fatty acid oxidation, and VLDL synthesis is also reduced. So lipids cannot leave the liver, so they start accumulating on the liver, and the first thing that happens in 90 to 100% of the cases, there is alcoholic fatty liver, also known as steatosis. Now steatosis can progress with the habit to steatohepatitis, which is alcoholic hepatitis. From here it can go in two directions. Either the liver can be cirrhosed, or it can directly start with hepatocellular carcinoma. So the other thing is, from steatosis the liver can directly progress to cirrhosis, and from cirrhosis to carcinoma. Now as you can see here, from normal liver to steatosis and from steatosis to steatohepatitis, these are reversible. So if there is abstinence from drinking alcohol, then the liver from here may go back to its healthy state. But once it starts cirrhosing or there is carcinoma initiated, it is difficult for the liver to resume its healthy normal functions. So these are the references that I have used to share my information and knowledge with you. Thank you. Now I hope you liked what we shared today. So keep watching my channel, like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Thank you.